Hello again. This video is on elasticity of demand. And for this video, the concentration here is how do we use Excel to help us? And at this point, I'm hoping that you've already looked at the activity in Blackboard and you've looked at the sheets example. And you may not have known exactly what you were doing, but hopefully after this video, you'll be able to go back and use the information that's presented here to help you work through those a little bit better. So the example that I'm going to use, Jan owns a business that creates web pages for many different types of clients. She has found that the demand for her services can be modeled by the function D of P is equal to 2 times the square root of 500 minus P, where P is the price in dollars she charges for 4 hours of her company's service. So the first thing that I've asked you to do here is just to write the revenue function, and that is review. And hopefully, if you're thinking about revenue, you're certainly thinking about P times D of P. And so if this was a question on your test, you would just write P parentheses 2 square root 500 minus P. And you could call that R of P. So R of P is equal to P times 2 times the square root of 500 minus P. So what I want to do here for a second before we go on, I want us to look at what this looks like graphically, because I really believe that showing you how this pans out graphically is going to help you understand these elasticity problems. In green, this is my revenue function. And so what you should have looked at in the for one of the handouts, the activity for elasticity, is that maximum revenue is achieved when unit elasticity happens. And that's when elasticity is equal to 1. So when elasticity is equal to 1, we also know that the derivative of our revenue function would be equal to 0. But if we're using elasticity as our measure of how we can raise prices to a certain level and max out revenue, we want to talk about elasticity. So on this piece of the function where the revenue is growing and the price is increasing because that's our independent variable, E, the value of E that we would get in our when we evaluate is going to be less than 1. That means that the function is inelastic, that we can raise price and our revenues continue to increase. However, once we hit our maximum, we hit 1 for elasticity, where our maximum revenue occurs, the values here begin to go greater than 1, and that means that in order to achieve maximum revenue, we would have to lower the price to increase the revenue. Remember again that price is our independent variable. So you may want to stop and look at that for a little bit just to make sure you understand what that is, but there is a handout where I've talked about that. But let's go ahead now and look at how we would do this in Excel. So here's my problem again. We've already talked about the revenue function, and really that's not needed so much when we start talking about elasticity. So for the next piece, it says use the elasticity function to determine the price Jan should charge her clients for 4 hours worth of service to maximize her revenue. So let's talk about how we go about doing this. One of the things that we want to do is I have not given you any domain here, so we want to set up what we call as reasonable domain. Well, we generally, in when we're looking at elasticity functions because of the function itself, we don't want to use 0 for price. But we can start off, say a dollar is the lowest price that we're considering. And maybe you're just going to look at some reasonable prices for 4 hours worth of work. I'm not sure what they are, so I think I'll start with those. Now, what I do want to do is pull out my elasticity function, because if you've not looked at what the elasticity function is, we need to break that down. Elasticity is the opposite of price times the derivative of the demand function all over the demand function. And in Excel, if we have set up P, D of P, D prime of P, then it's going to be very easy for us to be able to do E of P. Okay, in B, we're talking about the elasticity function. So let's go ahead and start looking at typing in some of these functions. So for D of P, that's where I'm going to type in my D of P function, which is 2 times SQRT, and you see it pop up there. And here we're going to type in 500 minus A2. Remember to close your parentheses. Enter that and double click that down. Now, where you're getting this num here, exclamation point, it might be that you just need to, you could do a couple of things. It's probably the value, for whatever reason, has gone negative, I would guess, and that's what's happening there. We'll just leave it for the time being and come back to it. Now we want to work on the derivative. So the derivative here of D of P, I hope that all of you, maybe on a separate sheet of paper, you would have worked it out, but I want to talk about how you could do it if you didn't work it out there. So that's going to be equal to 2, right, times, now this is going to be 1 half, because I know that from this function, 1 half is going to swing down, so I did that. That's going to multiply by, and certainly everybody, I know that's 1, but for the purposes of this illustration, I want to make sure that you're seeing this. So then I'm going to put in parentheses 500 minus, again, my price, close my parentheses, but now I'm going to raise it to the negative 1 half power, right? Because I'm taking the derivative using chain rule. And then I want to take, again, times the derivative of the inside, and the derivative, when I look here, of the inside would be negative 1. You may want to pause the video there, go back, make sure that you understand what I'm doing. But basically, 2 is the coefficient. I'm going to multiply 1 half times 2. I keep the inside the same. I decrease by 1 to get negative 1 half, and then I multiply by negative 1 because that is the derivative of 500 minus P, the inside. Hit enter and double click that down. For E of P, now it's just a matter of accessing cells. The one caution that I'm going to give here is that you cannot start off by just typing negative P. What you have to do in Excel is type in negative 1 times P times D prime of P divided by D of P. So look at how I've typed that in. Negative 1 gives me that negative P. Negative 1 times A2 times the derivative D prime of P, which is C2, all divided by D of P. So now I'm going to hit enter. And what happens is, you can see, this should make sense. That's a very small value, which if our price is at a dollar, we certainly would know that we would want to raise prices to increase our revenue. So what I'm going to do here is just double click down. So it looks like this value here is just not reasonable. Suppose we just for the time being put 500, see what that does for us. 500 gives us a little bit better value. Perhaps we could just put in 300, see how that works. Okay, so it looks like as we go through these values, it certainly looks like, well, at $200, we would definitely be able to continue to increase the price to increase revenue. And even at $300, we would be able to increase the price to increase revenue. But we know that $400, where that value of E is greater than 1, at 2, No, we would not want to increase the price. We would want to lower the price. So to answer part B, what we're going to do is we're going to goal seek. So let's use this value, this 2. And now for the first time, we do not want to goal seek to 0. We want to goal seek to 1. This is the only occasion, the only time you goal seek to 1, unless I've asked you to, is when you're using the elasticity function. The cell that we're going to change is still the input cell, our price here. And what you can see is that unit elasticity occurs, we get a value of E of P of 1 when our price is approximately $333.41. So this line itself is very important because you took your elasticity values, you goal seek your elasticity function to 1, and that gives you the maximum price to charge if in fact you were going to reach maximum revenue. I do want to show you something here. If I had a revenue column, okay, I don't, but I like to show this as a demonstration because I think for some of you it will help. The revenue column, right, is simply price times demand. And if I take price times demand and I double-click that down, I want you to look at the values that are happening there. One of the things that you can see is that my revenue certainly grows, and it looks like at a price of $333.41, I have this as my revenue, which is $8,606.63. At 300, you can see that it's lower there. If I were going to just work with the values a little bit more, suppose I wanted to insert if I insert $400, you can see that the revenue has gone down. It's just a good way to get an idea of how using elasticity is another way for a business to understand what they need to do with their price to maximize revenue. So let's take a look now at these other questions that we need to answer. The other questions that we need to answer are questions about what does it mean? So if you take a look, C here says, what is the elasticity of demand value at a price of 200, and what does that mean in this situation? So if you take a look at 200, at a price of $200, the elasticity value is 0.33. That means at a price of $200, you would want to increase the price to increase revenue. And then this last one, what is the elasticity of demand value at a price of $400? Well, at a price of $400, elasticity of demand is 2. We would want to lower the price to increase revenue. And I've actually taken and got some of these written out for you. So let's take a look at what we have. That's where I showed you how we got the derivative, and I just typed that out. And then these are what we would say to answer those questions. To achieve maximum revenue, Jan should charge a price of $333.41 for 4 hours of time. At a price of $200, demand is inelastic, and Jan should raise her price to increase revenue. At a price of $400, demand is inelastic, and Jan should lower her price to increase revenue. I hope that this overview using this problem will allow you to be able to work some of the other problems that we have in our lab manual and online in Blackboard regarding elasticity of demand.